When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me, stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble, just as long as you stand by me. And darling, darling, stand by me. Thank you.
I ask that you all remain standing as we go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we are excited today because we get to see you perform a miracle that only you can do. Joining two hearts, taking two lives, and making something brand new. Something that has never existed before. We honor you for it. We welcome your presence today and for the rest of their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. My name is Pastor Nicholas Fontana. I've been honored to officiate this wedding today. Luis, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior?
Yes, I have.
Nicole, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior?
Yes, I have.
Now, upon public profession of your faith, you have made known to all that the Lord Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. When two believers come before God to be joined together as husband and wife, he joins you together. Just as when you receive him as your Lord and Savior, you are joined to him. It is never his will for you to be separated. Here in our reading from Colossians, it says that you have become one flesh with the Lord. You are his, he is yours, you are one together with him. As the scripture from Colossians is read, I want you both to pay very close attention to the things that are said here. They are from God's word that the Holy Spirit will honor as we stand on them in faith and obedience. Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things, for you died to selfishness. And your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Right. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you are called to peace, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom, and as you sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The world has the idea that marriage is simply a legal contract, but at the same time it is a spiritual contract.
That's right. It's not bad, though.
Meant to be a lifelong agreement. When the words of faith are spoken according to the word of God between two believers, the power of God goes into operation. God honors their faith and brings them into union together. God's purpose for man and woman is to become as one flesh, as he has intended with the creation of Eve for Adam. A biblically based marriage is one that is in balance, with Christ as the head of the man and the wife together. The purpose of marriage is to spiritually, emotionally, and physically unite a man and a woman together as husband and wife in a relationship between themselves and their Creator. Let your life together reflect God's love in your hearts. Let your children live in God's love by your leading example. In a moment, we'll be reading from the Great Love chapter, but I want you to realize that apart from God, we are not capable of this kind of love. Only by remaining connected to him and being rooted and grounded in his love can you ever know and share this type of love. 1 Corinthians 13, verse 4, love endures long and is patient and kind. Love never is envious nor boils over with jealousy. Not boastful or conceited, does not display itself arrogantly, is not smug or inflated with pride, is not rude or unmannerly, does not act unbecomingly. God's love in us does not insist on its own rights or its own way, for it is not self-seeking. It is not touchy or fretful or resentful. It doesn't take account of the evil done to it and pays no attention to a suffered wrong. It does not rejoice in injustice and unrighteousness, but rejoices when right and truth prevail. Love bears up under anything and everything that comes, is ever ready to believe the best of every person. Its hopes are faithless under all circumstances, and it endures everything without weakening. Love never fails, never fades out, becomes obsolete, or comes to an end. To my witnesses, to all of you that are here, Jesus said in the 19th chapter of Matthew's Gospel, "Again I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them by my Father which is in heaven." You are not here just because of tradition. You are here for a very serious purpose, to bear witness forever of the miraculous union that will take place, and to add your agreement before God. Today is but one brief day in time. The promise is made today before God, and all here represents the love that these two share together that will last a lifetime. When we leave the ceremony today, God will go with them as they follow His word in their daily lives. This union is meant to stand the test of time. They have prayed, and before the Lord God Himself, they believe with all their hearts that it is the perfect will of God for them to be joined together in this marriage. They have made their decision, so from now until the end of this age, I charge you to do everything in your power to see that this union remains solid and strong and happy and prosperous. Luis, do you take Nicole as your lawfully wedded wife, according to God's holy ordinance? As God has brought her into your life, do you promise to be faithful, respectful, and understanding as you strive to live together in harmony? Do you promise to honor her and comfort her? Do you promise to provide her with your love and support as you journey together through this life, knowing that your marriage is sanctioned by God and that your lives are entrusted to Him?
I do.
Then turn to her, look dreamily in her eyes, and make this profession of your faith. I, Luis, according to the word of God, say please.
Say please. Oh.
Say, I, Luis, according to the word of God.
I, Luis, according to the word of God.
Forsake all others.
Forsake all others.
And join myself to you.
I join myself to you.
To be a husband to you.
To be a husband to you.
I take you, Nicole.
I take you, Nicole.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise.
I promise.
In the midst of our family and friends.
In the midst of our families and friends.
And in the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
To stand beside you.
To be beside you.
And love you always.
Love you always.
In all circumstances.
In all circumstances.
And in all situations.
In all situations.
I will be with you.
I will be with you.
And love you.
And love you.
For as long.
For as long.
As we both shall live.
As you both shall live.
Nicole, you take Luis as your lawful wedded husband, according to God's holy ordinance. As God has brought him into your life, you promise to be faithful, respectful, and understanding as you strive to live together in harmony. Do you promise to honor him and comfort him? Do you promise to provide him with your love and support as you journey together through this life, knowing that your marriage is sanctioned by God and that your lives are entrusted unto him?
I do.
Then turn to him and make this profession of your faith. I, Nicole.
I, Nicole.
According to the word of God.
According to the word of God.
Forsake all others.
Forsake all others.
And I join myself to you.
And I join myself to you.
To be a wife to you.
To be a wife to you.
I take you, Luis.
I take you, Luis.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise.
I promise.
In the midst of our family and friends.
In the midst of our family and friends.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
To stand beside you.
To stand beside you.
And love you always.
And love you always.
In all circumstances.
In all circumstances.
And in all situations.
And in all situations.
I will be with you.
I will be with
and
you.
And love you.
And love you.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
We each take a candle.
Damn. No kisses. You ruined everything.
From every human being, there arises a light that reaches straight to heaven. When two souls are destined to find each other, their two streams of light flow together, and a single brighter light goes forth from their united being. They do not lose their individuality, yet in marriage they are united in so close a bond that they become one. Now, following the profession of your marriage vows, we will light the large center candle from the smaller candles to symbolize this new reality. In this way, they are saying that henceforth, their light must shine together for each other, for their families, and for their community. Please lay it together. May I have the bride's ring, please?
Come here, Aiden. Turn around. Switch around. Oh, give it to me. Okay, thank you guys. Good job, guys.
This wedding band is a perfect circle of precious metal that represents your faith and your love. It is a never-ending circle that indicates the continuing love of God, a love that never ends. The love of God and the faith of God is what causes His power to move in our lives. Nicole, when you look at this ring in the years to come, may it remind you of your vows today, and may you always feel encircled by God's love, just as this band encircles your finger. Louise, take this ring, place it on her finger, and repeat after me. With this ring,
I thee wed.
You are my partner in life.
My love.
My best friend.
It is a token of my love.
In the sacred commitment. I have made here today.
Before God.
Family and friends. Marriage is a gift from God. He has created marriage as an institution between a man and a woman, and it is a continuation of His work of creation. Please, both of you, receive this gift with thankful hearts and strive to keep it holy and pure in accordance with His word. I'm going to say it again. Please look into each other's eyes. Please, both of you, receive this gift with thankful hearts and strive to keep it holy and pure in accordance with His word. Louise, when you look at this ring in the years to come, may it remind you of your vows today, and may you always feel encircled by God's love, just as this band encircles your finger. Nicole, take this ring, place it on his finger, and repeat after me. With this ring,
I thee wed.
You are my partner in life.
My love.
My best friend.
My best friend.
It's a token of my love. And the sacred commitment. I have made here today.
Before God.
Family.
And friends.
Locked together.
Forever.
Join your hands together. Now, by the power invested in me, by the state of New Jersey, and as a representative of Jesus Christ, before Almighty God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Luis Urbina. You may kiss you.
Beautiful, and I tell her celebrating the matrimony of